The Philippine Office of E-commerce giant Shopee reaffirms its commitment to curb the sale of fake goods on its platform. Andrea Taguines on the line with the details. Andy?
Hi, Ron. E-commerce platform Shopee insisted that it expressly prohibits the sale of infringing goods or fake goods after it was included in the Office of the United States Trade Representative's list of notorious markets for counterfeiting and piracy for 2023. The notorious markets list highlights online and physical marketplaces that reportedly engage in or facilitate trademark counterfeiting or copyright piracy. Despite the inclusion in the list, the USTR reported that the USTR report had cited Shopee's significant investment in its brand protection and anti-counterfeiting capacity over the past year, including the expansion of its one-stop brand intellectual property portal from an initial pilot to all rights holders and a new brand protection partnership program to bolster proactive screening measures. But it noted that despite these positive progress in reporting procedures and takedown turnaround time, rights holders noted that these improvements have not materialized consistently across all Shopee platforms. It added that rights holders continue to report high volumes of counterfeits across some of Shopee's platforms with complaints about persistent communication issues, slow response times, and weak enforcement against repeat infringers, particularly for Shopee Brazil and Shopee Indonesia. In response, Shopee said that it would continue to strengthen its anti-piracy measures. It said that it will particularly focus on brand protection initiatives to provide a safe and positive experience for the community of buyers and sellers that are using Shopee. The USTR report described Shopee as an online and mobile e-commerce market based in Singapore with individual country-focused platforms serving Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, Taiwan, Vietnam, as well as Brazil, Chile, Colombia, and Mexico. Meanwhile, the Green Hills Shopping Center in San Juan City in Metro Manila was also included in that report, the only marketplace in the Philippines that made it to the notorious markets list. And as of now, ABS-CBN News, we are still trying to reach out to the mall's management for a statement, but it has yet to issue an official response. Ron?
That report from Andrea Taguines. Thanks, Andrea.
El Salvador President Nayib Bukele re-elected in a landslide victory. Thousands of his supporters thronged San Salvador's central square to celebrate his re-election, which the 42-year-old leader dubbed as a referendum on his government. He has touted the success of his security strategy, where authorities suspended civil liberties to arrest more than 75,000 Salvadorans without charges. The detentions led to a sharp decline in nationwide murder rates and transformed the Central American country that was once among the world's most dangerous. Bukele will stay in office for another 5 years, becoming the first Salvadoran president in almost a century to be re-elected.
The Philippine Defense Secretary vows to protect the country's sovereignty amid secession plans raised by Duterte. Gilbert Teodoro Jr. asserts the National Defense Department will secure the integrity of the country's territory. The Justice Department echoing that sentiment by calling on the public to reject secessionist ideologies. Meanwhile, the National Security Council warns it will not hesitate to use force in quelling attempts to dismember the republic. Security advisor Eduardo Año says the proposed secession of Mindanao not only runs counter to the Constitution, but also threatens peace and development in the island region. This comes as Camiguin officials accuse ex-President Duterte and former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez of sedition. XJ and JJ Romualdo say the two are attempting to divide the nation for their own interests.
A Philippine lawmaker wants the Justice Department to reverse the prosecutor's decision to dismiss her grave threats complaint against former President Rodrigo Duterte. Franz Castro says there was no legal basis for the decision. She maintains all the elements of grave threats were present in her case. Castro earlier filed a complaint against Duterte after the former president allegedly threatened her life on a television show. But last January 12, the Quezon City Prosecutor's Office junked the complaint, citing lack of sufficient evidence.
Ako ay umaasa, no, na makikita ng Department of Justice yung mga justification natin doon sa habla na inano natin, yung grave threat. Yun nga, no, nakita ko talaga na napaka-unfair noong naging desisyon. No, hindi man lang, binayaan muna na magkaroon ng trial para makita natin talaga yung katotohanan. Di lang ito para sa akin, ano, para din doon sa mga tao rin na nakaranas ng injustice sa panahon ni dating Presidente Duterte.
Security is tightened in the Philippine House of Representatives complex after some lawmakers reported to have received bomb threats. The House Secretary General Reginald Velasco said Monday the precautions are similar to measures undertaken during the President's annual State of the Nation address to Congress. He refused to identify which lawmakers reported the threats, only that they were received on mobile phones. Velasco also said security personnel will be patrolling the House premises in Quezon City round the clock.
I have talked with the Sergeant at Arms and I told him to impose strict security to all those who are entering the premises, particularly the non-members of the House and who are not employees of this institution. Hindi namin alam, basta sinasabi lang na baka bombahin tong House of Representatives, mga ganun. But as I've said, we take all this threat seriously, so kaya we have taken special precaution.